Thank you for being part of this panel, and special thanks to Nitin and his team for conducting such event. It's a very good initiative, I'd say. Thank you all. So to answer the question, gone are those days at MIT where procurement guys are at the kind of behind the scenes handling the entire stress abilities to related to negotiations and ensure supplies comes at hotel at right time at the right quality and the right temperature guidelines and what we specify to the vendors. So with this kind of new, so a couple of things which I would like to highlight is look at the traditional, rather than, because we traditionally used to this traditional mode of negotiations wherein float these tenders, call these vendors for negotiations and things like that. But now with this kind of a different situation we are in, I don't think we'll be able to inculcate or get into a kind of a negotiation mode in a traditional way of negotiating the contracts. To my view, to optimize the cost, look at various other alternate options. Now we see with the kind of difficult situation in the market, everybody is selling everything. That could be one of the lead to us. If vendors are not taken aback with the kind of difficulties, why we should be taken aback with the difficult situation? So we should look at finding ways and means in terms of finding a right buy. This is the right opportunity for us to look at having, evaluating a right source and maybe a optimum source wherein we look at bringing efficiencies in our prices. Because now with the kind of challenges in place, you see the lot of people are selling anything and everything. Even one of our agency come to us, a software agency selling disinfection chemicals and things like that. So we're finding such strange things happening in the market. So it's maybe a right time to look at your vendor base and also look at where we can bring in efficiencies by identifying a right vendor. And now we've been all this writing in our policies and guideline documents that right product at the right negotiated price at the right quality. Now it is like really abiding those policy guidelines and ensure that we bring in efficiencies in what we source to our hotels in the coming days.
What I was about to say is, Mr. Goyal said, we will walk on a very kind of a positive mindset. And we see, obviously, in the next 2 to 3 months' time, we don't see the industry reviving so fast. But having said that, with people staying at homes for 3.5 months, 4 months, the frustration level and the kind of stress levels have actually increased a lot, and people would love to go out and spend their personal time with their families and things like that. So now, earlier days, we used to think that chutti nahi mil raha hai, we don't have time to spare with our families and all. Now with having spent so much time with our families for last 3.5 months without going outside, I think it's really time now to go out and then explore. Like, for example, there is a lot of positivities when you see the lockdown measures and the ease out measures being announced state by state. So it's not about talking anything specific about any specific state. Like, for example, Maharashtra, when you see the news came in yesterday where they have announced that in a phased manner, right from starting 2nd, 5th and 8th, they're opening up everything. In spite of having so many cases, there is so much of positivity where they are feeling that, yes, with the revival, I'm sure these difficulties will get overcome. And like other states, everybody is working on a very positive mindset. I think hopefully by another 4 to 5 months' time, I think we should have these businesses back to normal. Maybe not as big as like what we used to have happen. For example, our hotel industry, we used to say 2019 was the best year ever or whatever. So we are expecting that maybe 21, 22 could be a much more, far more better year in terms of our occupancies, in terms of our profit levels and even our service level deliverables. Now with we have with the situation in hand, now we have been really up our ante, our hygiene standards and drive actually deliver these hygiene standards to our customers. I'm sure people will come back.